I'm a dock worker at Uniport, small container terminal in the city.
Okay, and we've heard that dockers are a union, mm-hmm. very strong together, they stick together. And can you explain to us how comes that the dockers stick together?
Well, you have to go back in history, I think, because the work of the dock workers was a very filthy and dirty job in the 60s and the 70s. And then, because I wasn't in the ports at that time, so I have to talk from the history books. But at that time, somebody said, "Hey, that's enough. And now we want to get paid for the dirty job we have." And you only can do the job at that time when you work together. You cannot do the job alone. You need a good partner. You need a good team. It was really teamwork at that time. And the teams were very big at that time, so the was a brothers on the working floor, and that's where it started, I think. And for now, that's what I use for my colleagues to talk about is, I tell you where the money comes from. You don't get money, you don't get that good money because you're a nice guy or you got blue eyes, because they. Our foreigner dockers fought for that, and that's I want that the dockers to understand, and that's very important, because everybody, the whole society is going for the individual. Everybody's going for himself, and that's in the Port of Rotterdam same. But you have to help them to that you need solidarity, but otherwise they smash you, first one and then the other. That's why.
Do you think this will change now with this automated cranes?
Yeah, it will be more difficult, because they pull out the crane driver from the crane into an office, and then you're an office people, and office people are different than dockers. So you're not a docker anymore, you're an office employee. So that's, when I have to talk to an office employee, that's more difficult for me, because I don't know anything about the office. I do know about crane driver, but... And when you're in a company where they're all in the office, there's a whole other culture.
And how's the situation with those guys who lash the containers? How is the relation between them and the dockers, the crane drivers?
In my situation, the combination is very good, because we see them, we lunch in the same room, we talk to them, we work with them. But in a new situation, with the crane driver in the office, I don't know, because I don't work there. But that's more difficult, of course. We can see each other, because the crane driver on my terminal, he can see under him the lesher. And that's different than the new terminals.
Do you think it will be possible for the union to create these rooms for the workers again?
We have to, but like Niet told you, we don't know how, because we're not welcome on the terminal. We don't know the guys who are the remote crane operators. We call them the PlayStation guys, because that's the job you do. It's PlayStation.
Yeah.
And you get paid for it. So.
Is there also some kind of this automatization in other harbors?
Yes. Everywhere.
Is it spread? Or?
Yeah. Okay. It is.
Do you have experience, or do you know how the local unions in the other harbors deal with the new situation?
No, but they're solving with they have the same problems, of course. And for instance, America, the unions are much stronger than in Europe, because the union tells you how to work, and it's different. And Australia, the unions are strong as well, but they're trying to break it.
Yeah.
That's the same everywhere, I think.
Is there an exchange between the unions on different parts of the world to develop strategies how to deal with this?
Yeah, there is. Yeah.
how does it happen and what?
Well, for instance, I can only talk for myself, but I've with Nick, I've been in 2008. I've been to Australia, and there was a congress of the MUA over there, and I've been there for 7 days, and then you talk with dockers from Australia, and you talk, you network, and well, there were dockers from America as well. So that's how it works, and of course there must be you have to often meet each other, otherwise it don't work. But there is organization.
And these are meetings of rank and filers.
Yes.
Yes, I would like to know if there is a common passion of dockers and seafarers, for example, a football team or...
In Rotterdam there is.
Which one?
Feyenoord, of course.
Or there is a special music you all like, a television program?
No. I don't think there is, but the football club is one of the main thing in Rotterdam. You have a problem when you support another team.
And what message would you like to send to seafarers and fellow dockers around the world?
I think solidarity is a main issue, and that we cannot forget where we came from. And that's what I think is most important. They don't like you because you have blue eyes, or they pay you because you fought for the good salary you get down. That's
Thank you.
Okay, welcome.